Hi, and welcome to Unblocking the Blockchain. My name is Jonathan, and today we're going to talk about how to set up a phantom wallet on desktop. In my example, I'm going to be doing this on a Mac computer and using the Firefox browser, but this will work on pretty much any computer that has these particular browsers on it. So to get started, all you need to do is go to phantom.app. That's going to take you to the Phantom Wallet's official website. Once you're on their site, you can look around and learn a little bit about the Phantom Wallet. You can watch their video, but if you're ready, you can just hit download. It's going to let you know that they have a mobile version available on iOS right now. And then they also show the browsers that it's compatible with Chrome, Brave, Firefox, and Edge. Today, I'm going to show you how to do this in Firefox, but it is the same in pretty much every single browser. So I'm going to click this Firefox logo, and then it will launch the Firefox add-on extension store. And again, there's something similar in every single browser. And we're going to click Add to Firefox or whichever browser you're using. The Phantom Wallet will need access to different sites, so you're going to have to say that you want to let it have access to different sites, as you're going to need to sign in with your wallet to verify your assets in order to get access through NFT utility and whatnot. Once the extension is installed, you'll see this little icon in the top corner, unless you have them hidden in your browser. See, I have my MetaMask one as well. You're going to have two different options. If you already have a Phantom Wallet, you could always hit I already have a wallet, and then you could enter in your secret recovery phrase. Just remember, never give anybody, not even Phantom, your secret recovery phrase. Nobody will ever ask you for this. If they are asking for this, they are trying to steal something from you. I'm not a financial advisor and I will never give financial advice, but this is one thing that I will say: never share your recovery phrase with anyone. So we're not going to be setting up one that we already have. So we're going to go back and then we're going to click create new wallet. Now it's going to ask you to create a password. I recommend creating a very strong one, and make sure that you keep this password safe. Don't put it on something that's connected to the internet, because if somebody gets this password, they could potentially hack your wallet. Once you have your strong password created, make sure that you have read and agreed to their terms of service and hit agree, and then hit continue. Now this is where they're going to give you your secret recovery phrase. This is the key to your wallet. Just hover your mouse over the part that has the I with the slash and it will show you that phrase. Make sure you put this in somewhere that is secure. I recommend writing it down on paper or something physical, as well as putting it on something that is off the internet. If it's a flash drive that's password protected, that's off the internet, or if it is a hard drive or something that is not connected to the internet, because whenever it is connected to the internet, that is a weak point. And if somebody ever was going to get these series of words, they can get into your wallet and take all of your assets. Once you've written down and recorded your secret recovery phrase, you're going to want to click I have saved my secret recovery phrase, and then hit continue. It's just letting you know that they have shortcuts to bring up your wallet, and then hit continue again. And that's it. If you want to go hit up their Twitter and see what they have to say, and then also go and check out their help center to see what else they have as far as like resources, and then just hit finish. Now, if you click the phantom icon in the extensions in the top corner of your screen, it's going to bring up your wallet, and this is your wallet address up at the top. If you click it, it will copy that, and then you're going to be able to send that to somebody, and they could send you assets that are compatible with the Phantom Wallet. If you click deposit, this is where you could fund your wallet, and this is where you could send assets to somebody else from your wallet. And then this tab with the four squares, this is where all of your NFTs will live. The next tab with the two arrows that go back and forth, this is kind of a swap system where if you wanted to swap, say you have Sol and you want to swap it for an altcoin or something like that, you could do that directly with an app. So if I hit, say, one Sol, it's valued about $133 or USDC right now. And if I wanted to swap out that one Sol, I could do that and have that in my wallet, and I'd have USDC in my wallet instead of Sol. Then you'll go through your slippage, your estimated fee, and price impact to the liquidity pool. The little lightning bolt is just your recent activity. And if you go to the gear, you could rename your wallet, you could change the language, your address book, trusted apps that you will allow Phantom Wallet to connect to. You could change your password, which I recommend you do anyways on a regular basis. This one is an important one: auto lock timer. If you don't have an auto lock timer on your wallet, then anybody that comes onto your computer is going to be able to transfer your funds. So I recommend you have this and have it at a low number. Then you could change your network to things like testnet. You could export your private key, your recovery phrase, or reset your secret recovery phrase, but you will need that password that you created. That's why I said it's very important to keep that password safe and make sure that it is a strong one. I hope this helped you set up your very first Phantom Wallet on desktop. If you got value from this video, be sure that you check out one of these videos next. If you have any questions, make sure that you drop them in the comments, and don't forget to like, subscribe, and ring the bell, and I will see you in the next one.